I've wanted to be an artist since I was a child. Since I was about 7 years old, I never saw myself as anything else. That's all I've ever thought of myself as. And, you know, so when I got older and went to college, that's of course what I majored in. I majored in fine art. And then I became a teacher. And eventually I left teaching and I owned an art gallery for about 10 years in Groseal. And then that closed in 2008 when we had that economic recession, and I kind of wondered what to do, and I ended up, they had started having studios available here, and I really wanted to be here. I've been a member of the DCA for the last 20 some years, and I've always thought it was a good organization. So I put my name on a waiting list, got a studio, and I've been here, oh golly, I don't know, maybe 5, 6, 7 years, I'm not sure. But I love it here. I love that we can have some camaraderie with other artists. And it opens up opportunities for you too, because, you know, when you're around other artists, they see things that you might do, or something you want to, you know, they think would be a good show for you to be in, or gallery, or whatever. You're influenced also by your other artists. And also, Aaron looks out for opportunities for us. And, you know, I think more and more too, as time's gone on, she's found more and more opportunities for us to show her work or be involved in something that benefits us. I think for a long time, I look for emotional sorts of, I like exploring the emotional part of being human. So in the beginning, like I have some paintings in the studio here that are earlier ones, and they explored more of my own inner feelings about how I might just feel at a particular time. Over the last 10 years, that's kind of transformed into exploring more the outside world and our emotional response to that world. So for instance, a lot of paintings in the last 3 or 4 years have dealt with a lot of the societal turmoil we've been going through. And it really, of course, every artist, I mean, it's your own personal response. But in painting then, I'm hoping that, you know, someone else will also respond and, you know, get something from that, whether to think about something or whatever that might be. So a lot of them have had a political theme in the last few years. Some of them, I'm not sure if you call it political, but, you know, it's that response to the outside world now. And I know when people come to look at my work, those pieces that really convey that, those are the pieces people respond to. And it's not always positive. Sometimes people have negative responses, but as an artist, I just want them to respond in some way, you know, besides just, that's a pretty painting. That's not really, to me, enough of what I need to say to the world.
Hello, I'm Erin, the Executive Director at the Downriver Council for the Arts. Thank you for watching. We hope that you will find inspiration in these series of artist interviews. If you'd like more information on our organization, please visit our website at downriverarts.org or follow us on social media. Thanks. See you next time.